In this video, I'm going to show you how I spend a typical, peaceful evening alone by myself. On this particular day, it was a Sunday, and I had just gone out with a friend of mine to a beach, and we had seen each other, and it was so nice to see each other after having been apart for such a long time. I was tired when I came home, and I took a moment to wash my hands very thoroughly, of course, because I had just been out in public. And then I also used my favorite hand sanitizer that smells like lavender and bergamot. From there, I cleaned up the kitchen. I had done some cooking earlier in the day. I had made rice milk, and basically I had made kind of a big mess. So I like to clean up the kitchen always before I start cooking. Even if I'm really hungry, like I was on this particular day, I still take a moment to clean everything up and get myself organized before I prepare any food. I think that for me, preparing food in an unorganized or messy environment just becomes really stressful, so I like to take a moment to do this first. Then I went to go change. Although the outfit I was wearing was pretty comfortable, I mean, it's a giant sweater after all, I always like to wear pajamas or some kind of lounge outfit when I'm just at home. On this day, I chose to wear a nightgown with a robe over top. That's actually my most comfortable outfit. I have three different robes that I alternate between depending on the weather and my comfort level that day. And then I have a whole bunch of nightgowns or sleep shirts that I wear because I just find them to be a really nice, comfy thing to wear around the house. Then I put my mound of hair up on my head because I don't like my hair to be down when I'm cooking. And then I set out to prepare myself a really simple dinner. I was tired, like I said, and I was really hungry, so I wanted something that would be ready within about 20 minutes. I also wanted to clean out my fridge because I had a lot of things that were just hanging around from earlier in the week. So I decided that a pasta with veggies was my best option. Most of my recipes start out with olive oil and garlic, which is a really delicious way to start out a recipe. I then fried some mushrooms, and I added a whole bunch of dried oregano. I absolutely love dried oregano. I also added some black pepper, and I forgot to take the cap off before I did that, and a little bit of salt. I like to use sea salt in everything. Then I let them fry for a few minutes while I boiled the pasta. This is my favorite kind of pasta. I added my shredded carrot, and then I added some tomato paste. This tomato paste is called doppio concentrato, which means double concentrated tomato paste, and it's super flavorful and rich. Then I deglazed with a little bit of pasta water. And then I added my pasta right into the pan with all of my delicious flavorings, and I tossed it up. Tossing up your pasta is so important. I often see people put the sauce on top of the pasta, and to me it just kind of defeats the point because you want to have a mouthful of pasta and sauce and toppings in every single bite. I couldn't wait to dig into it, so I just had a few scoops of it by the counter and thought about what I wanted to do that evening. And I decided that I just wanted to take it easy and watch a show or a movie or something. So I got comfy on my favorite spot on the couch, put on my glasses, and headed over to Netflix to see what was on. I ended up choosing the documentary about Blockbuster, which was really good, especially because as a millennial and a 30-year-old woman, I grew up going to Blockbuster all the time, so it was very nostalgic for me. After I was finished eating, I lit some incense. I used to burn Palo Santo or sage, but then I learned that actually some of those plants are becoming endangered because people are burning them too much, and it's moved from a ceremonial burning to more of a commercial trend. So I've decided that I'm not going to buy those anymore. And I'm going to be respectful of nature, and instead I will just continue to burn my regular incense, which you can see I have these Papier d'Harmonie, which is a really nice incense brand that I've been buying for years. And I also have some little incense matches, but I decided that tonight I wanted to go for the full incense package. I think it's really important to cleanse my home and the feeling, the warmth of my home with incense, so I do this pretty regularly. After I was finished eating and while I was watching the documentary, I took a few moments to clean up my kitchen again. I really like things to be clean and orderly in my kitchen. Maybe it's because of my allergies and the idea that I don't like food to ever be hanging around or dirty dishes to ever be hanging around because I don't know what could be on them. Even though it's in my own home, I think it's just a mentality that I have where I like to see a nice clean surface and know that everything is sanitary. I then scrubbed the top of my oven to keep it looking nice and decrumbed the countertops. Felt like a good moment to make a pot of tea, so I filled up my kettle. I really do believe that water tastes better from a metal stovetop kettle. I know some people will disagree with me, but it's just the way I like it. I also took a moment to feed my sourdough starter. I had a starter culture that I was using for about a year, but unfortunately I stored it improperly in my fridge. And it took on some bad mold and would have been dangerous for me to use. So I had to completely discard it and create a new sourdough culture. And I'm still in the process of feeding this one to get it to a really nice point where it can make really delicious bread and other baked goods. So I feed my sourdough culture at least once a day, every day. And I'm currently using half spelt flour and half whole wheat flour. The last culture I had was just a pure wheat flour. It wasn't whole wheat, it was a bread flour actually that I was using. And so I add some water and my flours, and then I just stir it up. It's actually important to get some air into your culture. So it's really the flour, water, and air, and then the ambient bacteria in your environment that help form this beautiful, rich, tangy smelling culture that makes the most incredible breads. And I actually use my sourdough culture in pancakes too, if you can believe it. My kettle was boiled by this point, so I wanted to make myself a cup of orzo. A lot of people don't know what this is. This is a very traditional, old school Italian type of drink that usually kids would have or people would have if they were drinking decaf. They would have this instead. And it's made from barley. It's just toasted barley. Then I took my hot drink and went into the washroom to do a little bit of skincare. I'm very particular about my skincare routine, but I wouldn't say that it's overly complicated or involved. The particularity for me lies in the fact that I just have to do it every single day. And if I miss a day of my skincare routine, I tend to get an eczema flare-up. So while I enjoy doing my skincare routine, I would also say that I do it out of necessity because my skin has a delicate balance and I've learned how to keep it happy and healthy over the years. I don't really get breakouts and I don't really have too many other skin concerns, but eczema is definitely a big one for me because my skin can flare up seemingly without anything spurring it. This drink is so delicious. After washing my face with a very gentle cleanser, I then use my liquid exfoliant. I've actually been using this same liquid exfoliant since I was 10 years old. I then use my eye cream. I really love this eye cream. I've gone through a whole jar of it and I'm now on my second jar. And I use it pretty liberally. Then I moved on to my oils. I buy these oils individually and they are intended for the face. And I have three different oils that each serve a different purpose. And I just put a few drops of each one in my hand and then blend them together and gently pat it on my face. My skin is so dry that applying a whole bunch of oil doesn't even matter. It'll all be absorbed within seconds. And then the remainder I just rub into my hands. I decided that I wanted to bake something for the next morning because I really like to wake up and have fresh muffins or a fresh loaf of something or even a cookie, just something that I can look forward to in the morning. And I had some homemade rice milk to use up, so baking muffins just felt like the perfect thing. Although I do a lot of recipes and things that I've tested a million times for my blog, when I'm just home baking for myself, sometimes I just love to experiment without measuring anything, without really knowing where I'm going, and just see what happens and see what I can create. On this particular night, I was actually out of oil. I searched high and low in my place and I could not find oil anywhere. I don't think that's ever happened to me before. So I made this batch of muffins without oil. And I learned that the oil really makes a big difference. It's kind of a necessity. But nevertheless, I ate them anyways because I had baked them. I added some pumpkin seeds and flax seeds and chia seeds from my favorite nut-free seed company. I also added some of my favorite allergy-friendly chocolate chips. And then I just made a few little muffins that I could have the following day for breakfast. Now it was time to get ready for bed. I drink a lot of water, you might have noticed. Another thing that I'm particular about, and yes, I am particular about kind of a lot of things, is that my bed always has to be made. It doesn't have to be made absolutely perfectly, but it just has to be made. I really like to get into a fresh bed and a crisp bed. Then I took my ponytail out and did a little scalp massage to promote circulation of blood in my scalp. This is really good for hair growth as well. And I did some stretching and I also did my breathing exercises, but they look kind of silly, so I won't show you. And then I read and did some work and went to bed.